I always had the feeling that Selena was going to do something. Selena was a person that was very sure of herself, you know. I was too. I knew she was going to make it, even as a young girl, a little girl, you know. So apart from her talent, she had that charisma.
Welcome to Corpus Christi, Texas, a quiet, at times festive city where the people are inviting and warm, no matter the circumstance. This is a city that raised one of the most influential artists in music, and an artist that we still talk about till this day, Selena.
So we're headed to Q Productions. It is a production company and studio where Mr. Quintanilla and the rest of the Quintanilla family work out of. They also have the Selena Museum there.
We have, it's like a family business that's going on back in Texas. We have Q Productions, and it's an agency where we sign bands and we also book them.
She had this amazing talent. I really truly believe that not a lot of people possess that as entertainers. There's those ones that are just like, whoa, you know, and she was one of those. She was beautiful on the outside, she was beautiful on the inside. You could tell she was a genuinely kind person, and she generally loved her fans. So I think that that made her very appealing.
Selena's power was in her dancing and her stage presence, you know. And she's still very much with us. She would have wanted that because she worked very hard. She worked very hard, so.
I think that most Latinos, when they look at her, they see themselves, because she was not a güera and she was not blonde hair. She was, you know, dark skin, a little bit dark skin, tan, and she had the dark hair. So I think that most people could identify with her.
She would do things like, I would buy my food at the airport. We're waiting for flights, and I'd buy my little ham and cheese croissant, and she'd sit next to me. And so I'd grab my croissant, and before I'd even take a bite, she'd go, that looks so good. And I'd go, yeah, it actually is gonna be pretty good. And she's like, I just wanna bite. And on purpose, she would almost eat the whole thing. Just to get on my nerves, just to like, oh.
Selena was an international star. She wasn't just in Texas. I've always said that in Selena's case, it wasn't just the talent, it was the person. And to this day, people remember her.
One place that still remembers Selena immensely is Hi Ho Restaurant, one of Selena's favorite spots. The staff always treated Selena as if she was a part of their own family, and still do. Mr. Quintanilla and the rest of the family still stop by the restaurant till this day.
What was so special about her for you guys?
That she didn't act like she was special.
Yeah. Yeah.
She acted just like we are, you know. Yeah. You know, you could play around with her, and, you know, she'd come in and she'd come and hug us. Hi. And,
yeah.
You know, we'd laugh with her and joke with her, and, you know.
She gave us that one, and that's the only actual picture that we have of her when she, you know, when she was still alive. You know, we weren't the type to go, oh, Selena, you're at your autograph,
right.
You know.
Yeah.
We didn't expect her to go.
Well, because she also comes so regularly, right?
Yeah.
That morning that she died, we were here at work, and Abraham was here having breakfast. Somebody called him on the phone, and he came to this phone here. And I heard him say, she's not back yet. And he hung up, and then next thing I knew, they were leaving.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and then later on, my husband called me from his job, and he had heard that Selena had been shot.
Mm-hmm.
So that's when we put two and two together and said, no wonder he took off so fast. I made an announcement to all the customers that were here that Selena had died.
Yeah.
And it got very quiet. And a lot of people would cry, you know, would have tears
mm-hmm.
in their eyes. And she was very well known here in Corpus and very well liked.
What important.
What would you want to tell the people of Corpus?
Well, I'd like to tell them thanks for all the support they've given us. There was a lot of people that stuck by our side here in Corpus, and we give you all a whole bunch of thanks from the bottom of our hearts. We appreciate you made us what we are today, so thanks.
Selena just had a really important impact on me just because, like, she's a Latina just like I am, and she just opened so many doors for women. And being able to show, like, one of my friends the culture that I grew up in and showing her, like, this is me and this is who she represents to us as Latinas is really important to me.
No, pues como les decía, que siempre la vamos a tener en nuestros corazones. Es como si no estuviera muerta porque ella fue muy humilde con sus fans y siempre la vamos a tener en nuestros corazones.
She had such an amazing voice and the way that she learned Spanish because she needed to, because then they wouldn't accept her in some countries. The way she sang it was so perfectly when she like learned it that really touched me.
Well, we've been with Capital for about 3 years, and that was our initiative from the very beginning, was to cross over to the English market. And it's taken this long to finally, you know, get things rolling. And we're just really excited, and we just hope that, you know, we can do the best that we can and people accept our music.
Well, she was very excited about the English crossover. You know, she was really looking forward to that. She only got to record only 4 songs and she passed away.
The song that everybody likes, Dreaming of You, was actually the song that she picked. Selena heard something in the song that I didn't hear, and Dad also agreed with me. He's like, ah, it's kind of like we weren't feeling it, you know what I'm saying? But now you listen to the song and you hear that little piano part come in, and it's just like, it's a powerful song.
Late at night when all the world is sleeping, I stay up and think of you.
If you knew her, you'd know exactly what I'm talking about. When she loved hard. And of course, you know, her love for Chris was very strong. And even though everything happened with them, you know, my dad freaking out about them, you know, because she was very young, I'm kind of glad that it did happen that way, because, I mean, so much happened, you know, and then she ended up passing away. So at least she got to experience love. That makes me feel good. We're very close with Chris. I still consider him my brother-in-law.
Selena and Chris's love was admired because of how precious their relationship came off and how they both fought to be together. 2 hours away in San Antonio, Chris shares memories of Selena with fans at a signing for his book, To Selena with Love.
After 20 years since she's passed, I mean, there is great memories of being on stage and being on the road and all that stuff. But for the most part, for me, it was the more personal, like the car, the drives, certain drives that we would make from San Antonio to Corpus or from Houston to Corpus on our way home, or just getting home and, you know, having dinner and, you know, just the plain, what people would consider to be the normal part of our lives.
How's the married life?
It's great, I love it. I have no complaints whatsoever.
Does it ever get too much like this, since she's out there so much?
It took a life of its own, you know. I mean, we can't control that.
I just think about her. Everything reminds me of her. She's everywhere. It brings a smile to my face, actually. My wife and I will be riding in the car, and she'll come out on the radio, and we'll just both look at each other and smile.
It's hard. You know, I'm not going to lie. I'm not going to say that every day coming here, you know, I look at stuff in here, you know, there in the museum, and, you know, it's my office is right there, and sometimes it hurts. It hurts a lot, and sometimes I don't want to be here.
You can just generally feel her vibe, the good person that she was, the smile she always had for anybody, and her just way of being and her aura. I mean, I think that people are attracted to that kind of stuff, and she definitely had that it factor, which hasn't been figured out yet, but she definitely had it, and all of that put together, you know, I think that's the reason that she's still relevant.
I mean, I remember her every day. I mean, she's my little sister, so I'm freaking out the fact that it is been 20 years, because it realistically it doesn't feel like it's been 20 years. But I think it's because, you know, her fans have kept her memory alive.
A memory can't make you feel unsad, you know what I'm saying? There's nothing. If you're gonna be sad that day and feeling down, there's nothing that I've done in the past with her that can make that, okay, it'll make it go away. You know, that's the most important part for me, is keeping, you know, keeping her memory alive.
Somebody asked me the other day, if she was to be right in front of you, what would you tell her? I was like, I wouldn't even tell her anything. I would totally hug her. And then, well, what would you tell her after that? I go, no, I would hug her and hug her and hug her and not let her go. I miss her.
20 years after her passing, Selena is still present in the spirit of the city and in the hearts of her family. Everywhere you turn, there's a photo on a wall, a song on the radio, or a story being told. These are all reminders as to how strong Selena's legacy still is.